Let me ask you a question. How are you going to compute the sum of all the numbers in an arbitrary list like this? Confused? Are you thinking of using for loops and while loops? Well, let me extend this question. How are you going to write a function that calculates the sum of all the numbers in arbitrary lists like the below? Now, in this case, using a for loop or a while loop is not the solution. Why? There are two reasons. One, if you decide to go with for loop or while loop, you will need a lot of loops to go through every list in that list and calculate the sum of all the numbers. Second, it is never going to be a generic function, because as I showed you in the examples, the list can be as arbitrary as you can imagine. So what is the solution here? Well, there can be a lot of solutions to a problem like this. One of the solutions is recursive functions. Let's understand the concept of recursive functions using a simple experiment. Here, we'll try to find the sum of all the numbers in this list. Now, I know this list is way simpler than the arbitrary list I showed you before. However, if you can understand the concept here of recursive function, we can easily apply that logic to any arbitrary list we get. So now I'm going to define a function called addition and assign it a parameter array. This parameter array is going to take a list as an argument. Now, instead of using for loop, while loops, or the built-in function sum that I know most of you are accustomed with, I'm going to use the concept of recursive function. How am I going to do that? Watch. So I'll say here, if length array equal to 0, return 0, else return the first element of the list plus I'm going to pass in the rest of the elements of the list into the function again. So I'm going to say array 1 till end. So what does this function do here? So here I'm saying, check if the length of the list is equal to 0. If it is equal to 0, return 0. Else, return the first element of the list plus all the elements of the list, the result of all the elements of the list when they're passed into the same function. So basically, I am diverting this return statement to the function again. This concept is called recursive function. Now, let's go ahead and check the result. So here, I can say print addition, and then I'm going to pass in the list x that we have already defined. So now, if I print this, you see Python returned me 10. Now, let's go ahead and experiment with some other number. Yeah? Great. So 1 to 6, it is returning us 21. So the result is correct. Now, how is this function working? What is the objective behind calling the same function again? Let's go ahead and understand what is happening behind this function. What is happening is the function is calling itself recursively to compute the sum of the rest of the list. That sum is later added to the number at the front. When the recursive loop ends, 0 is returned as the list becomes empty. Let's look at this diagram closely to understand this concept even better. When we pass the list to the function, we get the first number 1 and result of passing the rest of the numbers 2, 3, 4 through the function again. Then, when we pass 2, 3, 4 through the function, we get the first number 2 and result of passing the rest of the numbers 3 and 4 through the function. This continues till the list is empty. When the list is empty, our code returns 0. So 0 is added to its previous return statement. The result becomes 4. Then 4 returned to its previous return statement, so the result becomes 7. Then 7 is returned to its previous return statement and the result becomes 9. Finally, 9 is returned to its previous return statement and the result is 10. Hooray! This is how recursive functions work. Now you might think, why go through so much complication to find the sum of the numbers in such a simple list? Why not just use a for loop or while loop or the built-in Python method sum? Yes, I totally agree. In this case, using recursive function is kind of an overkill. However, if we go back to our arbitrary list that we discussed earlier, recursive functions are going to be a huge advantage to use while coding so that they can deal with such arbitrary structure. Let's go ahead and check out how we can deal with it. So let's go ahead and figure out how we can use recursive functions to calculate the sum of all the numbers in an arbitrary structured list like this. Right? So here in my function, first I'm going to define a variable called total. This variable is going to store the sum of all the numbers that we are going to pass through the array. So here total is equal to 0. We have assigned it the value 0. Now I'm going to first say for num in array, then I'm going to check what is the type of that num. So basically what data type it is. If it is going to be an integer data type, we are going to directly add it to total. However, if it is not an integer data type and it is a list data type, we are going to pass, use the recursive function and basically pass that list again to the same function. So let's see how I'm doing it. So for num in array, if type num not equal to list, I can say total plus equal to num. Else, so I know there are only lists here, so I can directly say else. I don't have to say elif type num equal to list. So for else, I will say total plus equal to addition. We are going to pass that list again into the same function. So again, it will be processed in this function that we wrote. So I can say total plus equal to addition num. That's it. And then finally, we return total. Now, if I go ahead and print addition, and then we pass in the value, the x, the list that we have here, the arbitrary structured list. If I go ahead and run this, Python is going to return me 36. You can calculate for yourself. It is going to be correct. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8, 9 into 8 by 2, 9 fours are 36. So this is giving us exactly the sum of all the elements, no matter how arbitrary this structure is. For example, if I go ahead and place this here and basically again one here, no matter how much arbitrary I make, it is still going to return me the perfect result. So this is basically the advantage of using recursive function. Now I totally understand recursive functions are a difficult concept to grasp. However, I also believe they are a very useful technique in Python by which you can deal with such arbitrary data sets or data types in a much simpler way. However, in order to use recursive functions in your day-to-day programming, you need to be able to visualize the entire flow, how your recursive functions are going to help you solve the problem you want. In order to do that, you need to go ahead and practice recursive functions in your day-to-day programming life. However, if you choose not to use recursive functions, then also it's fine. I am now going to show you a way how you can calculate the sum of such arbitrary lists without using recursive function. Let's go ahead and solve this problem without using recursive function. In order to do that, we have to use a built-in method in Python called as extend. Now what extend does is, if you say list1.extendList2, it is going to put all the numbers inside list2 to the end of list1. In order to show you this, let us do a simple experiment. This is too complicated list, but let's do it with a simpler list so you can understand how this works. So now we are going to use this list to experiment with extend. So I can say here for num in type, not type here, for num in x, if type num equal to list x dot extend num. Now Here, let's go ahead and print num so we know what is happening, and also let's go ahead and print x. So at every step, in every iteration of the for loop, you guys can see what exactly is going on here. So now if I run this, you see, so first the iteration went through 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, none of them are list, but then it encountered a list 5, 6. So it put all the elements of this list to the end of the original list, so x basically. So it put 5, 6 to the end of the list. Then it encountered 7, 8, 9. So then it again put all the elements 7, 8, 9 to the end of the list. So we can use this same logic in our instead of recursive function. And what we are going to do is we are only going to find out the sum of all the numbers that are not within list, right? So basically, if I say here, if I go to this x element, and basically now if I do the same thing here, we will have all the numbers separately inside the outer list. And here we can check if type num is not equal to list, then we add it to the total. Else we just do array.extend, right? So let's go ahead and run this. Now if we run this, Python returns us 36, which is the right answer again. So what we did is, instead of using recursive function and then pointing that list again back to the same function addition, we just use the built-in method extend in Python to put that number as a separate number in the list. And then we are only adding that separate number to our total variable. That is how you can solve this this problem of finding the sum of all the numbers in this arbitrarily structured list, one with recursive function and the second without recursive function. So today we not only talked about recursive functions, how they work, advantages of recursive functions, but we also talked about the possible alternative to using recursive functions. Now, as a programmer, this is your prerogative how you want to program. You can use recursive functions if you are comfortable with them, or if you are not comfortable with them, you can always find different ways to solve the same problem. However, in my opinion, do try to understand the concept of recursive function and do try to play with it. It's a beautiful technique, and once you get the hang of it, you can easily use it in very complicated functions and problems, and your solution will be very quick. If you like the video, please share this with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. I will see you in the next tutorial.